This is life, and what a good time to be alive. Remember what a glory it is to be alive right now.
First of all, it's just
take a few breaths. Breathe in. And then out. And then breathe in.
Stop blocking my noses, that's nuts.
If you could just tell us how you're feeling right now in this moment.
I feel good. I have that water. I can hear the birds. I want my water. Where's mine? I left it somewhere. Or was that mine?
No, I don't know.
Yeah, I'm feeling great. There. What, are we rolling?
Yeah.
We're rolling. Alright.
Yeah, so go on, how are you feeling right now?
Yeah, I feel good. Just had Christmas and all that with the family, you know. Got these. So I can't hide, have to hide the advertising, but I've got these trousers here. Got my warm slippers. So gravy, baby.
Oh, gravy, baby. Cool, and then yeah, how old are you?
I'm 23.
And then, yeah, if you can just explain what you do day to day, life.
Day to day, I work, I wake up, I live, try to pave the way, make the way, and that's it really.
What do you mean by pave the way?
Pave the way is like, try to find a way to make it basically. Yeah, to make it, that's it.
But what does make it mean to you?
Make it to me, trying to find a way to like, get the money, buy a house, live my life, you know, with my family, my own family, hopefully one day and all that, yeah.
Live the life the way that you want to live.
Yeah, exactly. The way that I want to live it.
Cool. And are there any things that you do to help you to get there?
Like, I've been slacking recently, to be honest, but tried to read. Yeah, reading, I think it's important. Yeah, studying. As far as at uni.
Yeah.
But that's a lot of hogwash anyway.
Really?
Yeah, a bunch of hogwash. School in general is... It's too narrow, it doesn't teach you anything, it doesn't teach you the truth. It doesn't teach you about yourself. It doesn't teach you things that you need to know, that I feel people need to know.
Yeah.
So, it's just like... I think it's a mechanism to try and limit some people.
Yeah?
Yeah, that's how I look at it. To try and crop some people out.
But you have
kind of controversial, out. But...
Oh, yeah,
it is. Yeah, it is.
But, like, so basically that's what you feel since finishing uni? But how do you know that it hasn't taught you that, like...
Well, maybe that's what I've learnt from it.
Yeah, like, how do you know that? How did you come to the realisation that it hasn't really taught you what you need to know?
Just like, from when I, before, the expectations I had.
From, yeah.
Yeah, and I think I'll learn. I don't know, just learn, like, the truth, basically. I reckon it's from learning other stuff outside of it.
Okay.
That makes you realise more.
Okay.
Like, and especially the topics that you learn, it's just a way of, I don't even know, because... A lot of people can vouch and say the stuff that they've gone to uni, that they learned at uni, when they're working later in life, they might not have even needed it, because the job will teach you whatever you need sort of for that job.
Yeah.
So what are you learning there?
I suppose maybe the skills, but...
Yes, but potentially that's what they say.
Exactly, you can learn a lot.
The analytical skills and all that, yeah. Skill, I don't know. I don't know, but that's just how I feel.
And what is it, the other stuff that you have learned or you think that they didn't teach at school, what is it? And how is
knowledge yourself, that's how I'd summarise it.
Okay, but how knowledge do you, yourself. How do you, or how did you come across that?
If you're reading music as well.
Is it?
Yeah, music's good.
Nice.
Music's good. Music and art in general has always been like, you know, break down doors.
Yeah.
That sort of thing. Push the boundary. So that stuff you learn a lot from.
Yeah.
Music as well, for me personally, it's always been... Like, some people don't really listen to music enough, I couldn't understand it.
Oh no, yeah.
But yeah.
So, music, is there anything else? Books, did you say?
Books. Just talking to people.
Yeah.
Definitely.
And then how do you even embark on such a journey, you know?
So every day, like every day.
Well, you personally?
Me personally. I could talk about that defining moment that, you know, already when I told you.
Yeah, talk
about
it.
At the end of, it was at the end of year 11 at school.
Mm.
And I had a surgery, so I couldn't leave the house for like 2 months over the summer. And all that time I was just studying, reading, looking on the internet articles.
So you had time?
I had time, yeah. Like free time to yourself.
How long was it for?
No, probably like 2 months, I'd say. Oh. For like most of the summertime, so you finish school like June, yeah. Early July, August, September, yeah. Whole summer, basically. And then...
So you were at home most of the time?
Yeah, I was at home every day.
Okay.
I didn't even leave.
Wow.
Didn't leave for like weeks.
Did you get fat?
And weeks. No, I've never been fat.
Go on.
And then, it's like, I was reading stuff about government and all that type of crap. And the system, and the history, how it was founded, and these sort of things. And then it's eye-opening, you kind of realise more what's going on in the world.
Mm.
You know, what that might mean for you, what that might mean for everyone, really.
Because
there's always it's like a big picture, and you live your own little picture that makes up the big picture.
Yeah, definitely.
But the big picture is always changing. But you're not even aware of it because you're only looking at your little picture the whole time.
Yeah, yeah.
So it's like, I see the big picture now.
Yeah.
It's like, wow, that's mad.
Yeah. So then how did that affect you when you were a small picture? Like,
yeah, it affected me because then I felt like I wanted to be a revolutionary.
Nice.
But then I lost that energy, that's what I mean. I lost a lot of that energy.
And what did it feel like? That energy?
Liberating.
Nice.
Yeah, that's how I say it, sum it up.
Yeah.
I remember going into sixth form, a lot of people going to college and stuff, and everybody wants to have...
Yeah.
So everybody wants to sort of like look good.
Yeah.
Going to sixth form with these new people, going to college, you want to dress good.
Yeah.
And all that sort of stuff, and I wanted nothing to do with it.
Yeah.
I used to dress like differently, dress weird.
Did you?
Yeah.
Like what? Just
like, you can't even explain it. But I knew I wanted no part of it.
Okay.
Because that's why I didn't want any part of it because I knew it was all a lie almost.
Mm-hmm. So you wanted
nothing to gain from looking good and trying to impress people and all that sort of crap. And yeah, but I feel like the energy still stays with me, just not as much.
Yeah. So you kind of wanted to distance yourself from it?
Mm. Yeah, definitely. I distance myself from like people in general as well. But maybe that's not as good.
Yeah, yeah.
But I distance myself from a lot of things.
And so what was that stage like in your experience?
I don't know, I feel like if there was somebody else with me, it would have been different.
Someone else going
to the stage. Or someone else that...
Understood.
Yeah, understood, or maybe like we did it together. Because then sometimes I look back on that time, like now, where I get a bit sucked into what I call the lifestyle, like the dunya.
The dunya. I love that one. What's the phrase?
Like the dunya, it's like the world. So there's worldly things that we do, whatever it might be. It's
kind of material things.
Yeah, material, all that sort of stuff. You get sucked into it. When I look back on that time, I think, if I had done all this stuff, I would have been bigger almost. Like if I had just done what everybody else did, found that like year 11, year 12,
yeah.
13 that time, but then it's like I'm saying, if there was someone else with me, might have maintained it for longer. That journey, I felt like I was on the path of righteousness, path to liberation and revolutionary and all that stuff.
And it's kind of on hold now.
Yeah, it's on hold. It's on hold.
And when you say you would have been bigger, what does that mean?
Like bigger in the sense of the world.
Like.
So I would have been. I don't know. Like more of an icon, would have had more money, more connections, stuff like that.
If you did continue on the...
Nah, if I, like I'm saying, not if I, what am I trying to say? Yeah, if I had done what everybody else
yes.
did, yeah, that's yeah, yeah. what I'm trying to say. Then I would have been bigger in that sense.
Okay, got it.
Yeah.
And so now that it's like, I mean, how does that feel? Can you say it's on pause, but like...
Yeah, not great.
Oh, really?
What?
It's not great.
Yeah, it's not great.
Why?
Like, it being on pause. No, I don't know really. That's the thing, it's like, on the one hand, at that time I felt like that's what I have to do.
Mm-hmm.
Like, revolutionary type thing. Then on the other hand, now it's like, I have to live the worldly life.
Yeah,
you know
yeah.
what I mean? Talking about getting the money, securing the bank.
So,
it's like a way up, yeah, like, that's what it is.
But then also, like, I suppose, how do you find the balance?
Yeah, it's true. The balance is what's important.
Yeah, because we kind of have to live this.
Yeah, you have to live in the world.
Exactly.
Mm. But like I always say, I feel like either I'll just be rich and just, I don't know, live some big life, or you'll see me in some Chinese mountain.
Nice.
With some villagers learning some Tai Chi or some crazy stuff. I'm either in it to win it or I'm not in it at all.
Yeah, either side.
Mm. Yeah, I'm not really, I would not want to be, I don't know, living like some sort of, like, you know, get the job, get the house.
Okay, got it, like,
yeah,
in
some
the system.
Yeah, some sort of like, yeah. I don't want to do that. Either do it big or I'm not doing it at all.
Yeah.
Mm.
So, and then I have a question about, you say it's on pause now, but is there any, like, do you think that it's in your control, this whole thing that happened to you? Are there ways that you can help nurture it, develop it?
Yeah, definitely.
Go on.
Right, it's about, yeah, it's definitely your choice. Resistance and... Like I say, music is good in that way, also as bad sometimes.
Because
when I think about sometimes, when you listen to music or you do whatever, it's like, imagine somebody talking to you, the same thing, over and over again. You'd be like, what the hell? Without the beat and all the instruments,
yeah,
depending on what
true.
The music is, somebody was saying that to you, like you're having a conversation, then they're just talking the same. You'd be like, why are you sitting like a guy in my face?
Why are you preaching?
Yeah, why are you preaching nonsense as well?
Yeah.
So I think by resisting those things is good.
Yeah.
Like reading, I don't read a lot, I should read more.
So, yeah.
Yeah, definitely. But every day you have a choice, like every day you wake up, you have a choice. Sometimes it doesn't feel like it. That's what the problem is. When you realise that you have a choice, like, you can influence things.
Yeah, but how do you realise that?
Yeah, that's the hard bit. But that's what I'm saying. Like, I had the spiritual awakening. That's how it felt.
Mm-hmm,
that's when I realised it. Like, I felt like the power was here.
Yeah, man. You have
and now the power is out there. Do you know what I mean? It's
yeah.
like, where is it? So it's in the fog. You're trying to find it.
So is there anything that you can do, you think, that... Or are you going to do anything that can help you get clearer?
Yeah, like today I felt good. I was earlier just with Daniel. That's my brother, I was with him. We listened to that Akala Fire in the Booth Part 1.
Nice,
yeah.
There you go.
Yeah, listen to that if you haven't heard it. But,
it's good.
Yeah, but I've taken it in, like absorbing it properly.
Yeah.
And yeah, it's just deep.
So maybe that's it as well, just feeling, surrounding your life. With this.
Yeah, surround it with things that are positive.
Yeah.
But there's a lot of negative stuff around.
That's true.
Sometimes that like, you just can't help it.
Yeah.
Mm.
Yeah.
But sometimes I feel like maybe it's your destiny almost.
What do you mean?
Like you're saying, what things can you do to nurture it or for it to come to you, blah, blah, blah. Maybe it's just not meant.
Yeah, so basically you said that you would love, you wanted everyone to feel this experience.
Mm.
And then, yeah, can you just describe what it felt like a little bit more? If you can, in words.
Felt liberating, eye-opening, awakening. Felt like I knew part of the truth.
Nice.
Yeah, it wasn't nice, to be honest.
Did
just
it feel-
like, every day waking up, like, just feeling like... Oh, I can't even explain that. But it was kind of overwhelming as well.
Mm-hmm.
It was a bit almost depressing.
Why?
Like, overwhelming, like, whoa, like... on the one hand of it, that's a lot to take in for a young man.
Yeah.
I was only, what, like, 17 maybe?
Yeah.
You know, I imagine that's what Che Guevara felt when he jumped on that motorbike and he rid up and down South America. I was like, whoa. You know, then it's like, this is what I have to do, that's what you have to do after that experience. Maybe if you didn't do that experience, you would have become a doctor and just done whatever you, you know, lived those days, but yeah.
Did you think that there was something like guiding you? Or not really?
No, I'm guiding you. Nah, I don't really know, to be honest.
And then did it feel like coming home?
Yeah. Coming home like E.T. Nah, I don't know, it felt like I was saying to you one time before, I remember that time, it felt like I was at home.
Already?
Yeah, I was at home already.
Nice. And it was just like a revealing, realisation.
Yeah, like a realisation. Yeah.
So what does freedom mean to you?
Freedom means... not having to face the pressures of life. That's how I call it. Shouldn't be any pressures of life. That's how I sum it up. That's what makes people go crazy.
Well, the pressure, yeah.
Pressures of life. You know, because I don't know, it's just so simple, really.
What freedom?
Life.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So simple, but it's not because of all these pressures of life, like I'm saying. So yeah, that's freedom. Waking up just with love. Because why do you need to be angry? Sometimes you might feel angry, you might feel frustrated, but you're frustrated at what? At nothing that is even real almost. At life, maybe the way, maybe you haven't got this, you haven't done this, X, Y, Z. You know, you want your podcast to be sick, but it's just frustrating when it's not. I look about, yeah, all that stuff. And then you get these emotions that you don't need. Life is simple.
Yeah.
That's what I say.
So what did you say about freedom? Oh, the not to be, the pressures of life.
Yeah.
How do you personally not succumb to the pressures of life?
No, I succumb to every day. Every day, but
love it.
Yeah, it's hard. I'm trying to find the answer myself.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Nice. And is there anything out, like, was there anything you want to do maybe to help find the answer? Where do you, you know, where are you looking?
Yeah, that's why I reckon part of going to South Africa might help me in that sense. That's something that I wanted to do.
So, you're going to do?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It depends really what might happen, but that's something that I want to do. Because I remember I watched this play, I was like, I watched this play. And I don't know what it was, can't even remember to be honest, but there was a monologue in it. And it was like the speaker was speaking. And he was saying, gave like a monologue, and it was basically in the play, I think he'd gone to America. And then he was talking about going back to South Africa and blah, 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 back to his motherland and all that stuff.
That's where he was from?
Yeah, and it's like it was talking to me.
Oh, wow.
Like, it resonated with me.
What were you watching?
Because I was already feeling it. It was a play, I can't even remember what it's called, but all the people had come from South Africa. Okay. Some South African play, I don't know what it was, but yeah.
So physically going home then?
Yeah, then I was like, wow. But yeah, I need to do that then.
Because you're from South Africa?
Yeah, because I'm from South Africa. But obviously I grew up in the UK. I remember I went there when I was like 14. That was the first time I went there, and I met my dad and all that. And yeah.
So both your parents are from South Africa?
Yeah, both my parents were from South Africa.
And you were born in?
I was born in, Ireland. I was born in Ireland. And I lived there in South Africa when I was a baby afterwards.
Mm.
And then moved to the UK. Like 3 or 4, whatever. But I think it's similar to like my sister, like Emily as well, some similar thing like that.
What similar?
Like the experience she had in going there, I feel like she was like
so she, finding herself
almost, do you get what I mean?
Yeah.
But for me, it's more about understanding the history and the culture of where, well, some of my people come from,
basically. Yeah, yeah.
So, yeah.
So, you think that's going to help you towards freedom?
Yeah, I feel like it's something that I have to do.
Okay, good.
Yeah, that's it. That's how I sum up. Something I have to do. No, I will go definitely at some point.
Have you done much travelling or not?
No, not really. No. This is another thing. You know what, the last time I went on holiday to Denmark, that was last year, 2016. Before then, I went South Africa in 2009.
Okay.
So it's quite a long time, yeah, 8 years. Yeah. But, so, yeah, I don't know really. It's a good thing to do.
Because sometimes it can help you just.
Yeah, it can help you. But sometimes I feel like it's that kind of pretentious one.
Yeah, yeah.
Going to a bunch of places, yeah. It sounds good, mate. But for me, it's not something that I wanted to do all these times, like over the years. That's why I haven't done it, obviously. Like, I had money at different stages.
Yeah.
But I just never wanted to do it.
Yeah.
But I think that's part of being in the dunya and stuff. Maybe that's what it is. You know? Like, might rather spend that money on a car or spend money on this and that and all these things, but I think it would be a good thing to do. Yeah, to go travelling.
And then another question is, what does self-love look like, feel like to you?
Self-love?
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know, that's something that I struggled with.
You struggled?
Yeah. In recent history.
Recent history.
Go on. So maybe you're asking the wrong person.
No, that's fine. It's okay to struggle with it. But why? What? Can you just explain it a bit more?
Like, what's it called? What's that word? It's like self-esteem.
Yes.
Maybe my self-esteem was low. But to love yourself, I don't know.
Yeah.
Yes. I don't really know, it's an interesting question. I can hear someone creeping there.
Maybe you're not quite there.
Yeah.
But, like, what, I don't know, what would it look like?
I don't feel great. I don't even know what to say to that, to be honest with you.
It's fine.
Yeah, I don't really know what to say to that.
Maybe. Big question, hey?
Yeah, maybe I'll get back to you on that one.
Okay, cool.
And then I still got the tags that we had that week as well.
Another thing as well, what I was going to say is, if someone else, you said that, like when you were going through it, there weren't really that many people you could talk to. Say, if there was someone that would come to you now and say, David, like, I'm going through this crazy awakening, what would you say to them? Like, would you give them any words of wisdom?
I would just try to encourage it as much as possible.
Nice.
And tell them not to be scared, not to have fear. Yeah, just encourage them to carry on whatever they're doing or whatever that made them feel that way. Yeah. That's what is important, not having fear. But maybe that's why I went back to what I was doing before, for example, or just how I felt before. Because the fear to go all the way, maybe. You know?
Yeah, it's scary.
I think fear is a lot of things that limits a lot of people.
Yeah.
Well.
Yeah.
That fear or that doubt. I'd be scared that you won't be able to do something. Scared of, yeah. So it limits you, definitely.
Do you think you still have that now? Or?
Yeah, definitely. I have some fear, but for me, it's like at any moment, the beast will just come out.
The beast?
As in, like a lion. So I know, like, I don't even worry about it. That's almost how I say it. Because maybe there's a bit of fear, maybe I'll be a limit somewhere, but I know it's going to come out.
Okay.
Maybe that's next week.
Got it.
Next month, next year.
So basically right now you're not really doing anything particularly to help to get yourself back on.
Yeah.
Yeah, so basically it's coming.
It's going to come soon.
So there's no fear?
No fear.
Do you think it's coming for other people?
Yeah. I'd say this generation.
Really?
Yeah, this generation. There's a lot of people on that sort of... I'm that one. Where the older generation, I didn't think they had the opportunity to... They weren't allowed that sort of, you know, expression of themselves.
Mm.
So, yeah.
But you must be seeing this from what, social media, not necessarily your friends?
Nah, maybe some of my friends. Social media as well.
Okay.
Yeah.
Only because you said you didn't really... You want other people that you could kind of...
Yeah, but like close people.
Hmm?
You get me? As in... People that I know, maybe, like I remember my friend Rosanna, she was a good friend of mine. She was on all this back in the day.
Okay.
But I remember we used to be like, sort of like you're bugging out with all this spiritual crap that you'd be posting on Facebook, all that sort of thing.
Yeah.
You get what I mean? But, yeah. But I don't know, I didn't really talk to her much about that anyway. I didn't really talk to anyone about that. Could have been someone, for example.
Yeah, yeah. Why didn't you talk to her?
I don't know, I didn't want to. I didn't really feel like I needed to.
Okay, fine.
For like something that you do yourself at the same time, but yeah, maybe if there was someone like maybe if it happened and you, I would have talked to you now if it was then. Does that make sense?
Yes, again.
So given how you are, given how I am, given how we are, if it happened then, if that had happened now, for example,
mm-hmm.
what happened then? Then, for example, I might talk to you.
Yeah.
Does that make sense? Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. Cool.
Mm.
Is there anything else that you would like to add?
Mm.
To put out into the world?
Mm.
No, words of wisdom. Nah. I'm like, come on, I know you've got some.
Who am I to tell anybody? You know? I thought that would be arrogant of me to put words of wisdom. Words of wisdom must come from the wise man. I'm not the wise man yet.
Who's the wise man?
He's in the bushes. In the bushland in South Africa, the wise man.
Oh, you're gonna go and find him, I see.
Yeah, I suppose. Man, so thank you for listening. Hope you enjoy it.
Yeah.
Mm.
Yeah, no, it's good to just learn from other people, you know, to see their experiences and how they've gone through life.
I think to express yourself, like I said, express yourself.
Mm.
Like, it's not easy to do always, to express yourself honestly.
Yeah.
But yeah, that's a good thing to try and do.
Awesome.
Mm.
Cool, thank you very much for sharing your story.
Thank you.
Sensei. Do you want to give a brief just... description with what you do with your life?
What I do with my life, I live it. That's what I say, really. Live it, don't will, you know?
How do you live it?
How do I live out my days? I try to live each day as it comes. I try not to overthink too much. I try to enjoy myself. I try to spread love. And obviously Jess is loving it.
We were born to feel.